So Shebbyville picks up a win. Another game in District 8 AAA. A lot of us had our eyes on was the City Cats and the County Cats. Lawrence County picks up the win over Tullahoma 33-14. And joining us on the Sweet Tea Bakery Hotline to talk about that game is C. Scott Chastain with the Ticket Radio WHMT out of Tullahoma. Scott, how are we doing?
Well, Josh, we've had better nights when it comes to football games, but we're safely driving home, so we're doing great. How are you?
I'm not driving home from Lawrence County, so I'm probably better off than you are. It's not an easy trip to make back to Tullahoma. And, you know, it looked like a game where I'm not sure if it was Tullahoma playing sloppily on offense or Lawrence County just playing very good on defense, but I think I read where Lawrence County had six turnovers tonight. Is that right?
Tullahoma had
seven
turnovers in the game, Josh, and I don't know how many Lawrence County forced. I know certainly two or three Tullahoma turnovers were unforced. They were just sloppy with the football tonight, but despite having five turnovers with 5.5 minutes left to go, the Wildcats had the ball, Tullahoma Wildcats, had the ball trailing 19-15. Again, 5.5 minutes to go at their own 15-yard line. So Tullahoma still, with five turnovers, had a chance to win the game, but, you know, turned it over two more times, and one of those turnovers was a pick six by Lawrence County's Jacob Loveless. And Tullahoma, you know, seven turnovers, Josh, you're hardly ever going to win a football game.
Yeah, seven turnovers. And like you said, the fact that it stayed so close is really remarkable. And, you know, I was curious to see how the quarterback situation affected Tullahoma tonight. How did that play out, and what do you expect moving forward from the Wildcats as they have another week to kind of assess and adjust?
Well, there's not a lot of options here. We've been doing this all year. Tullahoma's played three quarterbacks in every game, and one of those quarterbacks is out for the year, so now the Wildcats are down to two quarterbacks. And, you know, teams are starting to figure out when Eli Groves in the game, Tullahoma's likely going to throw the ball. And when Cole Potter's in the game, Tullahoma's likely going to run the ball. And Lawrence County played that very well tonight, and Tullahoma didn't have a lot of success under center.
Tullahoma falls to 4-4 with that loss tonight. It really makes these last two games with Lincoln County and then the Coffee Pot game very, very important when it comes, you know, when you're talking about playoff positioning, doesn't it?
Yeah, it really does. I mean, you win those two games, you finish 6-4, you're going as a wild card. You're going to travel somewhere. If you split those two games, you know, Josh, sometimes you get in at 5-5 and sometimes you don't. Tullahoma doesn't have a great strength of schedule, so that's not a positive for the Wildcats. If you lose them both, there's no way you get in. So it's really all hinges on a trip to Fayetteville to Meadows Thompson Stadium next week. Tullahoma can beat Lincoln County, then you got to like the Wildcats' chances at home in the Coffee Pot.
All right, Scott. Well, buddy, we appreciate it. Y'all have a safe trip back, and we'll talk to you again next week in the pregame and the postgame, I'm sure, okay?
Great job riding solo tonight, Josh. We appreciate it.
Doing the best we can. I appreciate it.
Yep.
He's too kind. That's Scott Chastain with WHMT, the Ticket Radio out of Tullahoma on the Sweet Tea Bakery Hotline.